Greetings, fellow nerds. This is Jeff of Tal Flittermouse. Today's suggestion comes directly from Daniel Taylor, who wanted to see if tungsten is bulletproof. This is definitely one of the most expensive targets we ever bought. This couldn't have been done without you Patreon supporters. Thank you very much. Let's take a look at this mighty tungsten cube, which has no purpose at all other than a cool thing to display on your desk. Has this weird little plastic spacer in there for some reason. I don't know what that's for, but as you can see, that's what you get for about $150. It's kind of hard to explain how heavy this small cube feels. It only is about 40 millimeters by 40 millimeters, but it's unusually dense. I wanted to see what it would do in my giant 5-pound block of silly putty, and after about half an hour, we learned that silly putty is pink on the inside. I guess there's only so much you can do with a big chunk of tungsten, but I thought that was kind of neat. It's been a while since I've done a time lapse like that. This measures 1.5 inches by 1.5 inches, and then they went all metric-y and call it a 1 kilogram cube. So there you go.
Good afternoon, Talflater folks. Jeff and Officer Gregg back out here with you on a nice sunny California day. Here in Central California today, it's 108 degrees. And for those of you foreigners who speak Klingon, that's about 42 degrees Celsius. Hey, today we're out here shooting a little block of tungsten that Jeff picked up. This little bastard is awfully heavy, solid tungsten. And those of you who know anything about this element know that it's a very brittle metal. So we're gonna try it with a variety of different calibers. We're gonna start out with a 22 out of the Ruger Mark III. We're gonna move all the way up, 9mm, 40, 45, all the way up to the AR-15, and we have an SKS over there. And we're also gonna give it a try with the Weatherby PA-459 shotgun, shooting some standard old 1-ounce Foster slugs. See if we can shatter the thing or if it'll make holes. So your predictions right down here, right there in the comment section. Go ahead and make your prediction what you think it's gonna do. While you're down there, reach over here, right there, and click the thumbs up button and give us a good thumbs up. Also, this is between me and you. Jeff stepped out of the room. Get 5 of your friends to subscribe to Tal Flittermouse channel and let's get Jeff over to 1 million mark by Christmas, all right? Oh wait, he's back.
Oh.
So anyway, we're gonna shoot this tungsten that just fell on the ground.
Oh, you just broke it. Okay,
it
video's
just
over.
On the soft dirt.
Thank you, bye-bye. Yep.
Since no one has ever shot one of these tungsten cubes with a bullet before, we had nothing to go by. I thought there might be a possibility that a 22 could actually chip and damage this cube quite easily. But as you can see, most of the damage was done to the bullet and not to the cube. There is a slight impression there from the hollow point from the bullet.
Okay, 9mm hardball, round ball. Non-hollow point. Okay, whenever you're ready.
Smacked into the top left, did not dent the tungsten.
That's a good sign. It's because hitting that edge where you think it'd be most fragile,
yeah,
it didn't even affect it.
You can tell there by the lines on the edge, it didn't even chip it one bit. There is a little bit of an irregularity there, but I think that is just a bullet residue.
It's kind of bulged outwards.
Yeah.
And then look at the fragmentation.
Cloudy. Shot down. Yeah, look at the bottom there.
I don't know if this is going to last very much longer.
So if somebody's shooting at you and you use a tungsten cube to defend yourself, know that you're going to get a lot of bullet spalling shooting down from it.
You got a vest made out of like 50 of those things.
Yeah. Why don't cops make their vests out of this? Let me tell you, this thing is what? Would you say about 5 pounds?
No, it's a kilo, so it's like 2.2 something.
Well, that's super heavy. You made a vest out of that thing, you got problems.
Yeah.
Especially if you go in a lake.
The 9mm bullet is almost 4 times the weight of a 22, yet it's going about the same velocity. And even though it struck the corner of the cube, where we suspected it'd be the weakest, the cube had no problem, again, defeating this bullet.
45 ACP.
Yep, hollow point, spirit gold buds.
Okay, whenever you're ready. Keep going. There you go. Keep going.
Hit lower left corner. We're trying to get them on the edge here for you guys, so you can,
so that you we're can, trying to hit the center, but
so that you can see their
meant to do that.
Whether it chips or not. But that being the weakest point on the whole cube, it still did not chip.
And our poor little cone thing is, I think it's done. Darn it.
This 45 ACP bullet weighs twice as much as our 9mm bullet, and it's traveling around 890 feet per second. Again, the bullet strikes the corner of the cube just laps it off, and most of the damage occurs to the bullet and our little plastic cone.
Ready.
That I think it hit.
Yeah, because it threw it
off the table.
Yeah, only about 8 feet. Ready.
Now we're getting some major velocity. This bullet is traveling almost 3,000 feet per second, or about 915 meters per second. You'll notice that the bullet impacts and disintegrates long before the cube even starts moving, so clamping down the cube would make very little difference.
Oh, the first real significant damage.
Yeah, actually made a little divot, sort of like the lead plate that we shoot with the slugs.
I would have thought this stuff would have shattered.
Yeah,
I really thought.
Crazy. It's a very shallow little divot. You could probably see there if I turn some angles there. But still, that thing held up to an AR-15 round shooting a 5.56.
What's next?
It threw this off the table about, what would you say?
8 feet, maybe?
Sure. Landed in the dirt. And so we've got next for you the SKS shooting a 7.62x39.
Okay, I'm ready.
Yeah, I'd say that hit it.
Yep.
Same thing, about 8 feet down.
Okay, this 7.62x39 bullet is more than twice the weight of our 5.56 bullet, but only traveling at about 2,200 feet per second instead of 3,000 feet per second. And it appears because of that backspin, the cube is actually affected by the Magnus effect and is actually climbing a little bit, believe it or not. That's bizarre. Remarkably, the cube is still in one piece. It looks like the 5.56 round so far has done the most damage, making a much larger pit than our 7.62x39 shot.
A slug doesn't destroy it, I don't know what will. 50 cal! Oh, we forgot the 50 cal. Okay, I'm ready. Whoa!
Holy crap!
I think you hit it.
This 1 ounce lead slug was traveling at 1600 feet per second and is delivering almost 2500 foot-pounds of energy. Yet the tungsten cube survives. The cube was thrown close to 30 feet away and we had no problem finding it. Luckily it didn't go in the water.
I thought for sure a lead slug, 1 ounce slug, would damage the heck out of that thing.
So it hit it right there like a ship's bow. You can see that actually it was this way. Let's get it straight. You can see that one piece of it went off this side and most of the spalling went off to the left. But I don't know if you can see this on camera. That little edge right there is a little bit deformed. So that's.
Oh, it is. It is.
Yeah, that slug hit right
I thought it would chip the heck out of that thing.
It hit right on that knife's edge. Didn't do
that. That is some tough stuff.
No kidding.
Let's shoot it with another slug, man. We got one more slug.
You want to go dead center? Oh, you want to go on a...
Yeah, let's try to shoot the corner of it if we can.
Nice
little... Position it.
Yeah. Okay. One more slug.
You ready?
I'm ready.
All right, here we go.
Woo!
I really thought that the cube would have been in pieces long before we got to the shotgun slugs. After all, we all know someone who has a tungsten ring that has shattered when they dropped it. However, when tungsten is in its pure form, like we see here, it's actually a little bit malleable. It's not brittle at all.
I'm gonna get a good shot of that. Pretty tough stuff there.
No kidding, we should be building vests out of those.
Look at that melted plastic on there. What's that from?
That's the Coriolis effect.
Oh, the Areolas effect?
It pulls the plastic out of the atmosphere, concentrates it on the titanium cube. It's check it out on the internet, it's true.
Well, there you go. Much more bulletproof than I imagined.
No kidding, the magic bulletproof cube.
Yep.
When we first measured this tungsten cube, it weighed 1,009 grams. After we shot it, it still weighs 1,009 grams. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. Ta-da!
Okay, I'm ready. Oh.